So today, am I audible? Can I start?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today we will take the remaining important topic related to the firearm injury, that is external and terminal ballistic. In last lecture, we have covered about the interior ballistic. So what is the firearm injury? Firearm injury is an instrument or device with which it is possible to propel a projectile by means of the expansive forces of the gases generated by the combustion of the explosive substance. In short, firearm wounds are wounds caused by high velocity projectile like pellets or bullet. Pellets are used in shotgun or smoothbore firearm, while bullet is used in rifle firearm. In last lecture, we have learnt about what is interior ballistic, exterior ballistic, terminal and wound ballistic. So ballistic is the science of the motion of the projectile. Interior ballistic is the study of the projectile in the weapon. External ballistic is the study of the projectile in the air. And terminal ballistic and wound ballistic is the study of the projectile at the tissue level. So this figure explain about the proximal, intermediate and the terminal ballistic. All we have covered in a last lecture. Then the two types of the gun, that is the shotgun and the rifle. What is the difference? In the shotgun, the barrel and it's the inner is the smooth one. So it is called as a shotgun or smoothbore firearm. And in a rifle wire, there are grooves. So when grooves are present and the part which is the depressed part is known as a groove and the elevated part is known as a land. And that is the feature of the rifling. And why these grooves and these lands are present and its effect, that it gives the spinning movement to the bullet, it prevents oblique of the bullet, it increases the power of the penetration and gives greater accuracy for a longer range. That is the advantage of the grooving. So all these things we have seen in a last lecture. Now today we will concentrate. We have also seen about the makeup or the construction of the shotgun firearm ammunition, that is shotgun cartridge. Here pellets are present and there are the wads are present. While in this, in a rifle firearm, instead of the pellet, there is the bullet and no wad and cardboard is present. That is the basic difference between this. So all these things we have covered in a last lecture. In detail, what is the primer, what is the gunpowder, what is the difference between single base gunpowder, double base gunpowder, then triple base powder. Then what is the black powder? It consists of the potassium nitrate, charcoal and the sulfur. All these things we have covered in the last lecture. And how this occurs? It occurs, this figure is important. Hammer, when you pull the trigger, then what happens? This hammer goes forward, it touches the percussion cap, then primer detonates. Due to this, the gunpowder get detonated, it produces the gas, and due to the gas, pressure is produced, and due to that, the projectile, in case of the shotgun, pellets get out of the firearm weapon, while in case of the rifle firearm, the bullet gets. So that is the revision of the lecture what I have taken in the last week. Now we will concentrate on exterior ballistic. What is the exterior knowledge of the forces acting on the shot while it leaves the barrel till it reaches the target? So after that pellet or that bullet gets the velocity. Velocity is forward in direction as well as it is rotational. For revolver, it is 600 to 900 feet per second. While pistol, it is 1200 to 1440 feet per second. While rifle, it is more than 2000 to 3005 feet per second. So the rifle has the bullet which is come from the rifle, it has much more velocity, that is the 2000 to 3000 feet per second. So after that, what happens? It has the air resistance as well as due to the gravity also plays the important role. So it does not go straight. It has yawning, it causes yawning, it causes precession, and it causes the nutation. So remember that bullet do not typically follow the straight line. It has rotational forces that keep the bullet off the straight axis. So in VIVA it is called, a question is asked, what is yawning? What is precession? What is nutation? So yawning is the oscillation around the long axis. So you can see the figure. It is the oscillation around the long axis, while precession is a circular yaw about the center of the gravity, which takes the shape of the spiral. So like this, precession looks like this. That is the, this is the precession, and the nutation. Nutation is the rotational movement in a small circle which forms rosette pattern like a spinning top. So yawning is the, what is yawning? Yawning is the oscillation around the long axis. Precession is a circular yaw about the center of the gravity which takes the shape of the decreasing spiral. While the nutation, it gets the spinning top or the rosette pattern. So you can see again this figure, yawning, precession, and the nutation. So same thing, after there is air resistance and the gravity, that's why there is the curved part. So this figure gives you idea about this. It does not, so you can see that it is like this. So see the arrow, or here, from here it does not go in a straight line. So it has the curved path. So what is tail wag? Tail wag phenomena, that inside the barrel, projectile is supported by all of the barrel, but after entering in a new medium like air, it loses its barrel, so it overs. So that is known as a tail wag, and regains balance after the covering some distance. So inside the barrel it is support, so there is no tail wag. While after that it gets in a new medium, so for that it has a initial tail wag, then it has intermediate tail wag, and after that there is the terminal tail wag. So after entering new medium, it loses balance due to the air resistance and the force of gravity, and that is known as tail wag. So tail wag is present in initially, then in intermediate, as well as terminally. So intermediate tail wag of a secondary missile. So this figure explains that. Then what is the medico-legal importance of the wound ballistic? So from that, you know which is wound of entry, which is wound of exit. So from what distance that is fired. So direction of the fire and wound track, relative position of the weapon, victim and angle of fire, cause of death, manner of death, and identification of the fire. So that's why as a doctor, we should know in detail about the firearm injury. Why? Because from that, you can give this information to the investigating police officer. So by seeing entry and exit wound, from what distance it might be fired, what is the direction of the fire, what was the relative position of the weapon and victim, what was cause of death, what is manner of death, and identity. So if this much information you give to the investigative police officer, then it will be helpful to him for his further investigation. So that is the importance of the medical wound ballistic. So what are the components of the shot responsible for the domain? So there are different components, that is shot charge, like what is in case of the shotgun, it is pellet, while in case of the rifle, it is bullet. Then there is flame is produced. Due to flame, heat is there. There is hot explosive gases are there. Smoke is there. Wad is there. Unburned gunpowder and grease from the barrel. So all these present when one shot, when it is fired from either from a shotgun or either from the rifle. So at first will concentrate on a shot of a rifle firearm. So a single shot of a rifle firearm, all these things are there. What is the shot charge? In a rifle, it is bullet, while in case of the shotgun, it is pellet. Then there is flame and heat. Hot explosive gases are there, smoke is there, wets are present in case of shotgun firearm, unburned gunpowder and grease from the barrel. So all these things are present in a single shot. Either it is of a rifle firearm or it is of the shotgun firearm. So all has its important time being. Remember that it consists of this much complex one shot, and all this causes different effect on a body or on that wood. So flame causes burning, gases causes scorching, smoke causes dirt. We will see in detail afterwards. So firearm wound complex, that is, it depends, it affects on the body of the victim, it gives signs and symptoms at the place of the strike or target, with characteristic changes. Result is firearm wound complex, that wounding complex and non-wounding component. So firearm wound complex has four parts: an entry wound, a track inside the body, place of testing of the bullet or shot charge, and exit wound. So first it enters the body, then it takes its own track. Either that bullet or pellet remains inside the body, and if it has much more force, it may go out the body, then it has exit wound. So it has the four part, that is entry wound, then its track, either it remains inside the any body organ like liver, spleen, kidney, intestine, like that. But if it has a great force, then there may be the exit wound. So entry wound, we will concentrate on entry wound, single hole. So it, and now this entry wound is of a rifle firearm. And afterwards, we will concentrate on shotgun or smoothbore firearm. So size depend upon the skin elasticity, tail wag. We have seen what is tail wag, explosive blast effect of a gases, so that proportional to the diameter of the bullet. Smaller or much larger having this pellet shape. Shape depending upon the firearm with the target. If it is the perpendicular, then the shape is circular. If it has a slight angle, it has oval. If it is from a it changes longer distance, then it may be elliptical, or if it is much more longer, then it may be the elongated furrow. Then a entry wound usually has an inverted margin, but in exceptional cases, it may be inverted. And usually there is collar of abrasion, because when any bullet strikes, then it gives, there is a friction between the skin and that of the bullet. So it gives collar of the abrasion. So what is the collar of the abrasion? When a bullet hits to the skin, it causes the friction, and due to that, it causes the abrasion at the entry wound. So I have already explained that it has the complex, that only bullet is there, but with the bullet there is flame. And with flame, what will happen? If that flame or that is fired from a near shot or a direct in a body contact, then with the flame, what will cause? It will cause the burning. So this is the effect of the flame. Flame causes the burning of the skin. Then there is smoke. Smoke is also present. So with that smoke, what? There is the tattooing, or blackish color is present on the skin due to the smoke. And if you take the skin from a dead body and send it for the histopathological examination, it gives the histopathological pattern with the carbon particles. So you can see this, the violet particles, these are the carbon particles. So burning present in a few inches in case of a revolver, and 1 foot in case of a shotgun. Blackening, absent, and blackening is due to smoke. Burning is due to flame. Flame causes, due to flame causes burning. And burning is present only few inches if it is fired from a few inches in case of a revolver, and 1 foot in case of a shotgun. While blackening is absent after 1 year, and blackening is due to smoke. Tattooing is due to the gun, unburnt gunpowder. We have seen the types of the gunpowder. Either it is black gunpowder, potassium nitrate, carbon, and the char. So that is the, or the, it is of that of the smokeless, and it consists of either the single base, double base, and triple base. Usually nitrocellulose or double base nitrocellulose with a nitroglycerin. So they pierce under the superficial skin layers, causing the punctate abrasion of a small blood vessel under the skin. And this tattooing is not present or absent after 2 years. Means up to 2 years only tattooing is present. While burning is present. Burning is present up to the 2 inches, or in case of shotgun, burning is present up to 1 foot, while blackening is due to the smoke, and it is absent after 1 year. So burning, blackening, and third phenomena is the tattooing. And tattooing is due to the unburnt gunpowder, and it is absent after 2 years. And there is collar abrasion. Why collar abrasion? Because of the friction between that bullet with the skin. So these are the important phenomena. So the burning, then there is tattooing, then there is the gunpowder deposition or blackening is present. So burning, blackening, tattooing. Burning is due to the flame. Then blackening is due to smoke. And tattooing due to the unburned gunpowder. So gunpowder pierces the skin while stains the washer. So this is again the another picture. And it also, so second picture is that of with the blood stain. So skin changes. Gross splitting seen in high velocity bullet and contact wound, low velocity bullet, tail wag, rage gas penetration, blowback phenomena, bruising present, or it is due to the contact wound. The contact muzzle end is in a contact with the skin. It causes the, either if it is the pressure is less, then it causes abrasion. If it is with a great pressure, then it causes the tattooing. It causes bruising or contusion. So color of the abrasion, raw of the superficial skin layer while projectile enters the skin. I already explained, because there is the friction between the bullet with that of the skin. That's why color abrasion. And the muzzle imprint or bruising at a entry wound. Why it is present? Because of the direct contact of the muzzle end. While collar abrasion is present because of the that ammunition, that is the bullet, has a friction with the skin. That's why collar abrasion is present. So tail wag phenomena, atypical medico-legal importance, atypical firearm entry wounds, bigger entry wounds are present, X-ray shaped entry wound is present, keyhole or slit type of the entry, multiple entry wound with a single fire, for example, when it is the entered from a one hand, if it is in a closed gas. So there is wound of entry at the lateral side of a right hand, then medial side of a right hand, then it enters through the chest, then it exits to the lateral the left side, then again on a left hand entry wound. So a single wound can give a multiple entry wound as well as multiple exit wound. So these are the atypical, in that you have to think, but first concentrate on the typical one. So keyhole, or it is the usually, what is the entry wound is usually circular, or if there is angle, it is oval. But sometimes I have told you that it is slit like entry wound may be present. So see the collar of abrasion. So collar of the abrasion is due to the friction of a bullet with the skin, so it produces collar of the abrasion. So then after that, the wounds are classified according to the range of the fire. So contact wound entry, either direct contact and that contact is hard or firm or loose contact, then close range, near distance within 6 inches, intermediate regions between 1 to 2 yards and distance range beyond 2 yards. So it is classified depending upon the distance. So close contact or contact and direct weapon is contact with the skin. Again, it is divided into the firm contact and the loose contact. Then close range. Close range is up to 2 yards. Again, it is divided into the near distance within 6 inches and intermediate range between 1 to 2 yards. And there is the distance range that is beyond 2 yards. It's very important. So the firearm entry wounds are classified according to the distance range. Again, I am repeating, it is the contact entry wound. Then that is the weapon is direct in contact with the skin. So it may be hard or firm contact, or it may be loose contact, or close range up to 2 yards. Again, it is classified into near distance or within 6 inches, or intermediate at 1 to 2 yards, and distance range beyond the 2 yards. Contact firearm wound, stellate firearm wound, muzzle of the firearm present hard on some hard bony area as forehead and skull, gases can't enter the skull and escape from the side causing the laceration in the scalp. So it is the typical phenomena. What happens that it is in a direct contact. So due to that the gases enter in a near tissue and it gives the more explosive lacerative wound. And star-shaped projections are present in the skull. So this figure explains the. So there is the entry wound. So you can see the circular wound. This circular wound is due to the bullet, but this star shape is due to this lacerated wound or due to the gases entered in a near skin. So that is the stellate shape. So what are the features of the firm contact? It lacks exterior residue, no imprints of the component because firm contact is there. Burning, blackening, tattooing present in the track or interior of the wound or intervening bone. Pinkish discoloration due to the carbohemoglobin, that is the carbon monoxide is present and that's why the pinkish discoloration. So muzzle imprint on a close examination, entry wound of a variable shape with a collar. Why variable shape? Due to the gases. Then loose contact, a small gap between body and weapon. Circular defect is present. Why in case of the firm contact, the defect is of the stellate shape or that star shape. Color of the abrasion present, circular soot material. While this, then tattooing, blackening, burning in the wound track, no scorching, singeing externally, muzzle imprint is there, and pinky digital carboxyhemoglobin. Close range. Examination of the close is important because in a close range, clothes also get involved. Burning, blackening, tattooing is present on clothes. If there are no clothes, then direct on the skin. Collar abrasion is present. Grease collar or dirt collar. This grease collar. Collar abrasion is due to the friction of a bullet or pellet to the skin, while grease collar or dirt collar is due to the grease. Grease present. Margins may be inverted. Wad may be present in track case. Near distance, barrel is held close to the skin in a range, flame or smoke. Central defect is present. Collar of the abrasion is present. Inverted margins are present. Burning, scorching, singeing, blackening and tattooing present. Intermediate range is within 1 to 2 hours. Hole is present. Collar abrasion, inverted margins are present. Blackening fades. I have already told, as the distance increases, thus blackening is present only up to the 1 yard. So as it can, tattooing present. And tattooing is also absent after the 2 yards. So if all these are features are present, this blackening, tattooing, it is only present up to 2 yards. And if it is absent, then you can give the investigative clue to that the firing is more than 2 yards. The last feature of the distance range, that is hole. Collar abrasion is present. Grease collar inside the collar is also called as the smudge. No flame gunpowder effect. Like there is no blackening, tattooing, burning, scorching because it is of a long range. And these effects are only present in a close contact or near contact wound. Is it clear? That is up to 1 yard. After 2 yards, this blackening, tattooing, scorching, singeing, all these are absent. So the short note comes in a university examination, differentiating point of the entry fire, rifle firearm entry and the exit wound. So you should be thorough in this. So size smaller than diameter of the bullet in entry wound, while in exit wound it is larger than a diameter of the bullet. So in entry wound it is smaller in a diameter of the bullet, while in exit wound it is the larger. Edges are inverted in entry wound, common sense inverted in exit wound. Average and increased color present in, that is obvious in entry wound, while absent in exit. Burning, blackening, tattooing is present, depend upon the range. If it is a close and near contact, then all this present, but it is of a distant range, then that is not present. While in exit wound, obviously it is not present. Bleeding is less in case of the entry wound, while it is more in case of the exit wound. Fat extrusion is absent in case of entry wound, while exit wound fat extrusion is present or absent. Cherry red color due to the carboxyhemoglobin, it is present in a near and the near distant or close contact, while absent in a exit wound. Lead ring may be present. It is lead ring usually present again in a near or distant contact, while in exit wound it is absent. And all these differentiation are very, very well given in a Nandi book. After this, you read the this differentiating point entry and exit wound. Very important for your short-term girl to pass the second year MBBS forensic medicine examination. Many times this short note has come, differentiating point between rifle firearm, that entry and the exit wound. Now we will concentrate on the shotgun cartridge. You know that shotgun, only the posterior portion is made up of the metal and anterior portion is made up of the cardboard. And here the first there is the primer, then there is primer surrounded by gunpowder, then is cardboard, after that there are wads, again second cardboard, and after that these pellets are present. So these pellets are present. So pellets are types are called as bird pellet, buck pellet, slug pellet. Then the variable factors, range, gauge, choke, we'll see that. So after that, these are the types of the wad, like the depend upon the how many pellets goes, like a 2-2 or 4-4. So the pellets, different types, soft pellet, soft shots, then hard shots and slug is there. Depend different types, that these are the soft pellets, or that the rubber pellets are known. Hard shots, it is made up of the lead and the slug. So variation in the appearance of the, as the you can see, when it is of a near range, it is circular, then it becomes oval, then it is become the irregular, then as it increases, the pellets get dispersed. So up to 30 centimeter, it is circular, up to 30 to 1 yard, it is becomes the oval, then in the up to, then the satellite pellet holes appearing over 1 meter, and in a fib, there is the single satellite as well as around that there are small pellets are present. Same thing, appearance of the entry wound in a smoothbore firearm. Contact wound, A is contact wound and it is circular or star circle shape. B is a close range, again circular or star, short range with the hole appearance. At the medium range, satellite pellet hole appearance, that is you can see D, and E as the distance increases, central hole decreases, the size of a central hole decreases. And in Nandi it is given that up to 1 yard, up to 1 yard, if you measure the size of a wound of entry, and if it is 1 inch, 1 inch means the shotgun has fired from 1 yard, and if you measure, then after that, after 1 yard, the what you measure in inches, size of entry wound, that into 1.5 gives distance fired or the range fired from a air. So if it is the that whatever you measure, if it is more than that, whatever the measurement of wound of entry into 1.5, it gives range of a fire. From what distance that shotgun has been fired. And from a distance only, there is no hole, only small central pellet holes are present. Same thing. There are pellets in compact mass. Why choking is present? The effect that the for a longer distance, it should be as a compact mass. And if a compact mass is there, then it gives a straight line. And it goes, if all are in a compact, and it causes much more destruction. So as the distance increases, pellets start dispersing from each other. More dispersion as the distance increases, and few will hit the target. So the shotgun are more important from a close range. So are effective in a close range shotgun, while rifle are used for a longer range. Same thing, different shapes of a contact wound, circular, oval, star, crusade, or irregular shape. Firearm exit wound, in case of this shotgun, exit wound mostly in a 90% case, the firearm exit wound is not present. But if it is with a firm pressure, and in rare cases, if it is present, only few pellets will go outside the skin, and so that it produces the exit wound. There may be multiple exit wound because the pellets, as the energy in the pellets are there, then there are maybe single or multiple. Maybe a large typical exit wound with the eversion margins, no close range characteristic, and exit wound color of the object. Shotgun wounds. Contact shotgun wounds are most destructive, I already said, because gases are more. Bursting rupture of the head is rule than the exception. Skull may be largely fragmented, leading to axial fracture, and scalp is extensively lacerated. So this is the shotgun wound complex. So this picture explains this. So by contact of 2 feet, birdshot produces a single wound. By 3 feet, there will be rat hole, a type of the entry. By 4 feet, satellite pellet holes. By 10 feet is greater variation in the type of the entry as the pellet disperse. On a body is roughly equal to the distance from the muzzle in a, already I told. Wad may travel up to 6 feet and may be found in a track. Billard wad ricochet important in giving the billard wad ricocheting is a phenomena and important in a distance of the fire. So the loose contact, that is wound of enter and wound of exit. Now we'll have questions. What are the important definitions? Bone of the skull is diploid, so has 2 layers. Table with which it struck first by projectile is supported from below so that the wound of entry at first on outer side, it is the circular hole. While there is no support in the inner table, then there is the beveling. Again, the wound of for it is for the wound of entry, and for wound of exit, for again it goes struck into the inner table, then here it is again the smooth, and when it exit from outer table, it is bevel margin. So punch in and punch out margin. So punch in and punch out margin, these are the viva question asked in a examination. So here you can better explain. So punch in, where the bullets, this is the skull bone. So first it is like there is the support of this, so there is the regular or circular wound, but here is no, so bevel margin. Again here the inner table, so it is again the smooth, while the bevel margin. So remember, wound of entry at first it is smooth, then in the inner table it is bevel. Again, inner table of a exit wound, it is the smooth, while the outer table, it is bevel. So, both that the outer table of a entry wound is a smooth, while the outer table of a exit wound is bevel. Same thing, the inner table of an entry wound is bevel. Why? It is the smooth in case of the this one. So punched in hole is present at the entry wound and punched out at the exit wound. So that is the thing. So at the first striking, it is the circular, and at the inner table, it is bevel. While inner table of exit wound, it is smooth. While that of the outer table of a exit wound, that is known as a punched out, that is the bevel margin. Same thing. Bird shot, size of a pellet is 2 to 9. Buck shot, pellet larger than size 9. Dust shot, pellet smaller in size. Blank ammunition, there is no pellet, only powder is present. And dum-dum bullet, either non-jacket or partial, they may expand or flatten on impact, thus increasing the energy. Again, these all are the Viva question. So bird shot, size of the pellet is 2 to 9. Buckshot, pellet larger than 9. Dust shot, pellet smaller in size. Blank ammunition, only powder. Dum-dum, that it splits when it strikes, or the it is non-jacket or partially jacket. So again, important thing, that is dum-dum bullet is a hollow point and expanding bullet, that as the pit or hollowed out of the shape, generally it expand when it the, you can see this figure, that the hollowed point is there, and it is the when it strikes to the skin, it expand and gives much more distension, and that is known as the dum-dum bullet. That is, it has the hollow point and it expands after striking to the skin. So ballistic coefficient, efficiency of a bullet in overcoming the resistance is the ballistic coefficient. Fragmentation is breaking of a jacket of the bullet is the fragmentation, usually present in dum-dum bullet. Embolized bullet, which is present in the blood circulation. Swallowed bullet is present in a GI tract. Tandem bullet, that you when you there is only one bullet remain in a barrel after the one you fire, and when you fire secondly two bullets come consecutively, that is known as tandem bullet. Ricochet bullet, which deviates from its path, that he at first it struck to the another thing and it deviates from, it is known as ricocheting. So tandem bullet, when you fire